after being held prisoner in a house of horrors, allegedly starved and chained to furniture at the hands of their own parents, the Turpin family's adult children now have a hopeful look towards future, and that includes pursuing their educations. Since they were homeschooled and primarily forced to read the Bible, the siblings are eager to acquire the knowledge to become regular school and university students. They are all bright and articulate and incredibly eager to study. Caleb Mason, an attorney for the seven adult siblings, tells People, "The thing they want more than anything else is an education." David and Louise Turpin's 13 children range from age 2 through 29, and the seven adult children were separated from their six younger siblings when they were rescued from their Paris, CA home in January of 2018 after a brave 17-year-old escaped and called 911. They all began receiving hospitalized medical care to help them recover from horrific malnutrition after allegedly being fed only one meal a day and never allowed to go outdoors in the sunlight. The adult children left the Corona Regional Medical Center on March 15 after receiving treatment there for 2 months. The group of siblings are now living together in a home in rural California. Now the adult children want to catch up on what they missed out on from being deprived of a formal education. Their lawyer tells the publication that the first step will be helping the adult children obtain a high school diploma or GED. Mason is even working with local university officials to put together an educational plan for all of them, and says the siblings, for the most part, have not had any kind of formal schooling. He says that none of them has had what I think anyone would consider adequate exposure to education, and that is what we are trying to remedy right now. After allegedly being held captive inside the family home for most of their lives, the siblings want to be fully engaged students and interact with others in a classroom setting as opposed to taking classes via the internet. According to Mason, they do not want to be sequestered doing their education online, he says. They want to get the same sorts of education as anyone else. We are hoping that we can find them within the next couple of years sitting in a college campus taking notes like anybody else. They have the same spectrum of hopes and dreams and educational aspirations as any other group of young adults, Mason says. After everything those poor siblings went through, to have the prospect of them attending school out in the real world, making friends and enjoying a normal life seems like such a happy ending.